Welcome to Ask the Pro. I'm your host and your coach, Chris Dufay, and this is where I'm going to give you what's needed to create the online business, the money, the freedom, and the life that you want. Now, this episode is by popular demand. If you've been following me on Facebook or Instagram, you would have seen that I went and presented at two online marketing events not that long ago. One was in Bangkok for DNX, which is just for digital nomads, and the other is for James Schramko's event, Superfast Business Live in Sydney. So what I'm giving you in this episode is actually the recording of my presentation at Superfast Business Live. So I want to say a big thank you to James for being a legend and growing a great community and having me speak, which I'm totally humbled with the world-class lineup that was the speakers that I got to share that stage with. Now, this is where I'm going to walk you through and break down some of the major points that I've gone through myself. So I saw this as an easy and a real and upper hand as a speaking at such a high-class event because I got to tell you about the real-life lessons and how you can use this. So obviously, I want you to really soak this up, enjoy it, and obviously take action from everything on it. Now, before we jump into this, I want to say a big thank you to obviously My Body Blends, as this is why the Ask the Pro podcast is coming to you, and obviously my favorite, the Superfood Elixir. So if you want the fuss-free, the proven programs, the guides, and the products to transform your body and health, be sure to head on over to mybodyblends.com and tune into the My Body Blends podcast show, as I'll be able to bring you the new episodes every single Monday, going into the insights of top coaching to be able to transform your body and health. Now, if you are loving this, make sure that you subscribe if you haven't, and even click on over to give me the feedback and review to make sure that I'm giving you exactly what you want. Also in that review, I'd love to know what you're getting out of tuning into the Ask the Pro show, because this is what I'm doing it for. It's for you. This is why I put the effort into making sure we're publishing these episodes along with the videos all on askthepro.com. Now, talking about askthepro.com, to really get the most out of you being here with me, to get the show notes and links from this episode and every other episode to jump on into the actual backlog of the library, make sure you head on over. Also, if you're looking to be able to grow your following, or if you want to double to triple your clients, or if you're looking to how to start and even grow your online coaching business, then head on over to chrisdufay.com/start here. And for you to get the most out of you being here with me, to get the show notes and links from this episode and every other episode, to jump on into the library and make sure you can soak up everything that I've got for you, even if you're looking to actually get the coaching to know how to grow your following, if you want to be able to double to triple your clients, even if you want to learn how to start and grow your online coaching business, then head on over to chrisdufay.com/start here. That is where you're going to be able to get the actual coaching to make sure that I give you exactly what you need, depending on where you and your business is right now, depending on where you want to actually take it, what you're defining success and where you want to take your business online, then I'm going to be able to give you that. So it's a quick quiz thing you can take, and then obviously I can direct you to exactly what you need. So head on over to Chris Dufay, that's chrisdufay.com/start here. Now, let's get on into this presentation. Soak it on in. It's a little bit longer this episode, and I just wanted to keep it in for one for you so you can use everything and make sure you pull the trigger on after it. And then I want to hear from you after the episode. Jump onto social media, jump onto chrisdufay.com, and then get in touch. So obviously I'm giving you exactly what you need. It's called Ask the Pro for a reason. You've got to ask, and then I'll be able to give it to you. So here we go.
Our next presenter is someone who was sitting in this room last year at this event. He's a member of Superfast Business. He's a physical trainer guy. In fact, yesterday when we had the expert slash silver circle meeting, I asked everyone what their superpower was. I didn't have to get an answer from Chris because, I mean, obviously he looks like Superman. Chris, please come up here and share your story of from sitting in the audience to what you're up to this year. Chris Dufay.
Thank you very much. Just before I get started, I was speaking at another event just 2 days ago in Bangkok, and there was a quote that was running through my head, and it was, if it were just more information that we needed, we would all be billionaires with perfect abs. And I think this is absolutely perfect. What are you really here for? Are you just here to take more notes? Absolutely, you can implement those. But are you just hoarding information over and over? And I think what the upper hand that I have is I get to stand here today and give you what I've been able to use, the trials, the tribulations, and the elations for what I've been able to actually learn. Because it was just last year, me sitting smack bang in the middle of this room as a complete newbie. I'd only just started. I was a personal trainer by trade. I'm actually from Manly. This is my hometown. I've been able to move to Dubai, be a top personal trainer over there. Now I'm living in Bali with my family, running my online businesses. Now, as I was sitting in the middle of the room, I felt like a complete monkey. And the problem is with monkey is they fall into traps. And it's proven. With study, it is actually proven. A bunch of scientists grabbed some monkeys, put them into a cage, and they added a ladder with some bananas at the top of it. Now, what would actually happen? The monkeys walk in, you beaut, there's bananas at the top. So one starts charging on up, but before he gets to the bananas, fire hose comes on, they're all absolutely soaked in freezing cold water. They all lose it, don't know what's going on. Anyway, I'm hungry, another monkey goes back up, but again, it happens. Fire hose comes on and they're all sprayed with cold water. So they soon learn, don't go up the ladder, otherwise we're all going to get cold water, not nice. But the experimenters do something very, very interesting. They get one monkey out and they replace it with a new one. The new monkey comes charging on in. You beauty sees the monkey, starts charging, sees the bananas, starts charging on up the ladder. But as he's going up, the other monkeys pounce on him and beat him on back down because they don't want to get the cold water on him. So he quickly learns, okay, don't go up the ladder, otherwise I'll get my ass handed to me. So the experimenters keep doing the same thing again. They change one of the old monkeys for one of the new monkeys and they keep learning over and over and over. At the end, all of the monkeys have been replaced with new monkeys. Now, if you asked the new monkeys, why do you not go up that ladder? They would all just say, because this is the way things have been done. They don't know what truly the reason is that they're doing it. And the biggest thing is that we have to do right now is we have to ask better questions. Because by asking better questions, you are going to get better answers. Well, I see the point why I've been able to create the success that I've had so far, even though in this room there are people crushing it. And I love coming to these events and it's fantastic. But I was able to ask a different question. I stopped trying to look at what was being regurgitated in the fitness industry. And I went, what was working out in the business world? What could I take out into the world and then bring it back to my hub, my niche, my specifics, my forte? That obviously one thing, that's why I resonated with James. I saw what he was doing. It was simple. It was to the point. I can action it. And when I actioned it, I saw results. And this is where we need to be looking at. You need to be asking the right questions right now. So before you start go running off at the end of these 2 days, ask yourself with this book full of notes, what do I actually have to do? What really matters? What is going to get me to my result? And it's been covered in the theme a few times, which is fantastic as well. We've had the 80-20. Again, if you do an 80-20 of the 80-20, you get 6% of your efforts is 64% of your results. That's a tiny amount of what you could be doing that equals such a large amount of what you can be achieving. And this is what we're truly here for. If I ask everybody right now, what do you want out of life? What do you want? What is the meaning of you having a better business, having more profits? What is this? It boils down to, well, I want to be happy. And this is something that I'm really passionate about getting to. For me, happiness is about having freedom. Why right now? I was literally stuck in a gym, whether it was in Sydney or whether I was being a top paid personal trainer in Dubai, training actors, top bikini models, Arab sheikhs, the lot. But what I didn't have was I was selling my time for money. I was trapped in that. Now I have the freedom. This is middle of the week, middle of the day, and I'm able to take my daughter down to the beach and start goofing around and playing sandcastles. This is what we're really here for. Success comes in multiple currencies. Financial is just one of those that you need to be achieving. There can be freedom. And what I like to look at as is I want to be doing what I want, where I want, when I want, and with whom I want. And have you ever asked those four questions to yourself? And have you ever truly answered them? And have you ever designed your business to actually achieve those at the same time?
We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in a split with so much more for you. Now, I know you're listening and tuning in because you know how important your health is and how this can also catapult your business. This is why I'm very happy to say that this podcast is sponsored by My Body Blends and my favorite, the superfood elixir, the powerful greens drink. Now, this is designed specially to boost energy, aids detoxification, enhances the ability to burn fat, supports healthy carbohydrate metabolism, and best of all, is voted best tasting greens drink. Now, myself and the My Body Blends team are looking for ambassadors to join, so you and your clients get the health benefits plus adding in a strong income stream for you and your business. The ambassador program, which is by application only, means you get exclusive access to sell My Body Blends products like Superfood Elixir to your clients, plus giving you the special ambassador pricing and bonuses. So once you become an ambassador, you can join the other top health and fitness players that are adding thousands to their week's income. Now, there is only a limited number of ambassadors we are taking on board, as this is a tribe leading the way together. So to apply and to join, go to mybodyblend.com/ambassador or add the checkout code that is TURNINGPRO, all one word, when you're going to get your own superfood elixir to order, plus you're going to get free shipping and a bonus to save yourself over $250 instantly. So just use that coupon code TURNINGPRO in the checkout and you can save over $250 right now, all on mybodyblend.com.
And there's three steps to your business to be able to get there. And what I was able to, after learning, after failing so many times, and I know if we can look at things and go, okay, there's not really a failure, it's really just a learning. Okay, that's fantastic, we can do that. If we looked at your business, basically there are two things if we boil it back down to. One, do a great job and give a world-class experience. And two, let everyone know about it. Now, we know in business, there is traffic, there is conversions, and there is economics. With the traffic side, how are you driving more people to you, to your business, to your offer? With the conversion side, I'm going to show you today how I went from loathing it and hating it to it actually being an enjoyable process. And with the economic side, I'm actually going to show you a story that John Logar, that you'll hear speak tomorrow, I had a really quick conversation with him in Bangkok as we're at an event very similar to this. And we had a quick chat and how that added thousands of dollars of pure profit to my back end. Now you need to ask yourself, why is your marketing not working? Are you working hard enough at it? And we've seen the quote that came up in the Twitter before, just working 40 hours doesn't mean anything other than more than you're working 40 hours. Are you really working when you are working? Are you talking to your market the way that you need to be talking to your market? Can you finish their sentences? For the fitness side of things, I knew my market inside and out. I was a really overweight, struggled with eating kid. For the fitness business side that I run and the mentoring, I struggled building my personal training business for years. And what did I need to do to be able to get out of that? The other important part with content, and I think it was fantastic that I get to lead after the presentation that was so phenomenal just before, is I really believe in the content that you have to be producing. Even with the e-commerce, the physical product company that I've just started, going into the nutritional space, the way I want to enter this space is I want to educate people. What if you were actually sold something and were able to use it to work? Now, in the actual supplement space, that's a bit of an anomaly. I'm actually a bit of a got a two heads in that space because everyone's just trying to jam down more product by you. But what if I could give you the product that worked with the actual information that was able to help you get there at the same time? And I'm going to pose something really important, that content is not king. And we've all done it before. You've published a podcast. You've put a video out there. You've written a really intense blog article and you've hit publish and you didn't wake up the next morning with 20,000 sales, but you heard crickets and nothing's happened. And the reason why is phenomenal content is king. Absolutely phenomenal. Are you able to talk that direct message that your customers and clients need to be hearing? Are they frothing at the mouth about it? And if you're not, you need to deep dive into what you're actually producing. Now, what you can do right now is draw two vertical lines straight down your page and put these three headings straight at the top. Message, market, media. If we have this triangle of a match, you are able to start creating a perfect line. And by the end of these 2 days, you should have one perfect line of what this is going to be. And you put every piece of your effort into creating this. What are all the different types of the messages that you and your business can create? You have multiple different benefits. What are those? List them down. Just brain dump this. What is the market that you're talking to? Obviously, we can have one niche, but are there multiple niches that you're going after? Are there multiple avatars that you might be able to talk to? Again, list them all down so you have an understanding of who you can talk to. And then with media, what are the different mediums that you can be using to talk to? Do you do it via video? Do you do it via podcast? Do you do it by blog articles? Do you do it by what social media platform? Then line them all up. What is the one message to the one exact market through the one medium, and why are you not doubling down on that? There's your 80-20 that you can execute. And the important part of being able to produce the content that gets people moving and taking action is having influence. Do people really care about what you say? This is something that's really important because you could put a real big effort into what you're producing. It could be really high quality, and I'm sure that it is. It could be a bit better, and I want it to be. But are people really listening? And this is where you need to be able to create influence for yourself. For the fitness side, I started off doing really small seminars, just to a couple of people, teaching them how to get in better shape, teaching females how to burn off stubborn fat, teaching guys how to actually look good and feel good. And then it went to seminars. Now, you know, just a few months ago, I held a 7-day intensive to personal trainers, teaching them how to get people in shape, charging them $8,000 for a week and having a group of 30 of them. It becomes a pretty profitable venture when you do that. Another one coming up in Bali later in the year. How can you be reaching up and how can you be doing this so people take notice of it? I flew back from actually doing a course in Australia, got back to Bali, we dropped the bags off, I got my little girl to sleep, and then I checked my phone and a new podcast had downloaded. And it was from Taki and James, and I was like, oh, fantastic. And it read 100K abs. I was like, oh, I don't know what this is. It must be in fitness. I'm so into this. It's fantastic. Taki's over there, James is over there. I didn't even know they were publishing it at the time. And I saw it, and I was like, fantastic. I listened to it. I go, they're talking about me. This is unbelievable. I cannot believe about this. They're talking about how I was able to start my business mentoring, and within 5 months of starting, I broke the 100K a month sales mark. I was like, okay, this is really good. How can I use this though? So I went to John Lee Dumas. I said, hey, John, here's an article and a blog post that was done on me. Here's where I can deliver what I think to the EOFI community. Phenomenal, Chris. Let's get you on. Oh, fantastic. I'm now an entrepreneur on fire. How can I then reach up to someone else? I just had Jordan Harbinger of The Art of Charm, a phenomenal following he has, was able to get him on board, and it continues on. What steps do you need to be taking? And importantly, as you reach up, what can you do for them in every single time of that? Now, just 30 minutes from here, my very first job in the actual health and fitness industry was at HMAS Penguin, a naval base from here. And there is a little military terminology known as an OODA loop. And I use this to get people started to be able to get you to process what's going on. Now, past this, you can boil this down to a shoot, move, and communicate scenario. Now, the important part of this is you are not going to be perfect from the start, because otherwise the cycle would just go shoot, because then you would have nailed him and then you just walk away. No, that's not what happens. You need to refine the process and constantly move. So that's why I want you, and you need to, from today, from tomorrow, you need to take action on something. What is the most important thing that you can do? Shoot. Then, is it working? Then, how do I do it better? And then repeat the cycle over again. This is how you can have expansive gains through your business really quickly. One of the key things I think my personal little power is speed of implementation. I will act on things really quickly. I've already put things into sitting in the silver circle yesterday. I was able to act on them last night and put them in. They are now working. By the end of the process, we came to a 2-5-21. And it's important to have a process to doing this because I want to be able to do something once and I want to be able to be paid over and over for that again. Just like the effective hourly rate, I don't want to be pissing my time away. And when it comes to content, I don't want to be spending a lot of time. So how do I get more out of this? So this is the simple process I came to. I would record a podcast episode. I would then use what I wrote down to record that. I would shoot a video. That video would go on YouTube and can be posted on my blog. I'd then cut that video into a 1-minute segment, organically upload that to Facebook for a bigger reach. I'll then cut that 1-minute video into a 15-minute segment that then goes straight onto Instagram. I'll then get my assistant to get another image and post that up as a status. In a really simple workflow, I was able to create multiple pieces of content over multiple pieces of mediums, talking the same message and hitting what I need without me having to be in that process a lot. It was very simple to be able to do. So by the end of it, I was able to walk out. Each week right now, I'm able to publish 2 podcast episodes over 2 different podcasts, 1 fitness, 1 on business. I'm able to publish 5 videos every single week, and then there are 21 social media posts that go out. With very little work, I'm able to get a content machine rolling. And this is what you need to ask yourself now. How can I step this process out together? Now we come to the conversion side. And this was something that I loathed at the start. And this is something really important that you need to probably take a photo of or start writing this down, because you're going to want to get a part of it. Do not do this. We've all done this before. We've all made it too complicated. This is just a screen grab. Like, this is no importance whatsoever. Make it as simple as possible. I've done this. I will put my hand up first. And I've absolutely boiled everything back down into one simple flow for what needs to happen. And it can be as simple as having 1 video, 1 lead magnet, 1 offer, and there you have it. It's a sale. And I found it, especially for my top ticket. The simplest version is always the best version. And this is where it's really important for you need to be breaking everything down right now. Ask yourself the hard questions. What is working? What is not working? How do I do things better? For me, on the conversions aspect, I put together a video series. I would shoot videos in my backyard, and I know, and I'm not poo-pooing them, but I haven't done webinars. I haven't done them. I did it through video series. One reason why I didn't do webinars was living in Bali, it's fantastic. Sun's good. Food's good. The internet, I honestly think carrier pigeons could do a better job. So I went down this route. And again, it's something I can do once and it can just keep steamrolling ahead for me. So I got better and better and better. And I know a lot of people are really afraid of doing video. But if you shoot a video and then you watch it and you don't like it, you've got one upper hand. You can delete it and no one will see it. And it's okay because you can walk back out the backyard, you can shoot another video, and you can continue that process. Shoot, move, communicate, and continue to make it better. With the end of the conversion process, we have the buy versus apply process. All 3 of my websites, you cannot buy anything from those actual websites. If you just landed on my homepage and went through, you can't buy anything on all 3 of them. It is all about getting people to create a relationship with, to then I can see if they are the right fit, to then have them on board. And this is why, especially with my business mentoring, is I only want to be working with people that I want to work with. The energy vampires, the shit kickers, I don't want on board. You can't pay me enough to hate my life. I don't want you there. So this is why, really easily, I want you to get onto my list. So therefore, building lists is my sole focus of my websites. Through the emails, I'm completely focused, literally taking 80-20 a little too far, but 80% of my emails are content, 20% of my emails are sales, where I'm pushing a sale. And I'm not half-assing it, I'm pushing a sale. I'm saying this is where it's at, this is the next step that you need to be taking. Though the important part is from the email, there are only two things I want people to do. You either click reply or click apply. So you're either going to reply to my email where I want to read your email. If you click reply from one of those, I'm going to get a really good snapshot from what's going on in your head right now. You're going to tell me what is your problem, where are you struggling with, and then I can sit there and actually spend my time because I know you're hot to trot right now, and I can be like, well, this is fantastic. I can give you a good, honest reply about what's going on. I also get a good sense if you're a right fit. And then I'm able to then take the next steps. And if you apply, I can start the vetting process. You can fill out all the different questions that I want to hear from you. If you use a type form, whether they choose one answer over another, you can direct them off. If they say aren't earning the right amount of money that you want them to be able to come on board, you can then direct them off and they go to another page. Thanks, but no thanks. Or you can direct them off onto what they need to be doing. The main thing about after someone comes on board, and I was so scared of this when I first started, was getting on the phone with them, doing a sales call. I was shitting my pants. And I didn't want to do it. For me, this is one of the most enjoyable things I get to do 3 times a week. I get to get on a phone with someone, and I know they've already passed so many of my boxes that I've wanted to be ticked, and now I'm able to talk to them and ask them the real questions. And then I'm able to be really easily, this is your problem, this is the solution, this is how you come on board. And then it's done. And for an $8,000 program that takes 90 days to go through, that's a really simple process. And it's that easy to be able to do. And at the start, it was just like that email sequence that I was showing you. It was way too complicated and it can be so much easier. Now we come to the economics part of your business. And one of the biggest parts of your business that is struggling right now, and it's because of you and your belief. Now, when I was in Bangkok for an event just like this, John Logar was there and we're like, let's meet up. So we met down in the lobby. Anyway, we got chatting. John was like, what are you up to? What's going on? And I was telling him about everything. I've started my business mentoring. It's going really well. Like, this is what's happening. These are my problems. And he starts shaking his head. I'm like, oh, I've pissed John off. What have I said? Am I looking like a peanut? Like, what's happening? He goes, you're worth more. At the time, I was charging $6,000 for the mentoring program. I was like, oh, okay. And he goes, it should be $8,000. I was like, John, like, this isn't chump change, mate. Like, come on. Like, I know I'm worth more. I just had one client, a personal trainer in Finland. From our very first call, he's added to, on contract, $420,000 of sales of training. From our first call, he was able to implement it. And it came through asking a different question. I saw something that he'd not thought about and he'd been able to pounce on it, and it's $420,000 per year he's able to act on and get trainers to follow through with. So anyway, with John, I'm like, okay, well, guess what, mate? I've got a sales call literally 20 minutes after we're going to wrap up our little chat here, and I'm going to give it a crack. So I went upstairs, had a shower to get ready for the talks after it, but I had this sales call first. And I was like, this is going to bomb, but it doesn't matter. When John talks, I respect him. I'm going to do it. Let's do it. Anyway, I get off the sales call, off Skype. I grab my phone. I owe you a drink. The most seamless sale. He was like, yep, fantastic, done. Yep, already clicked the link, paid it, cool. All right. What was standing between a $6,000 program and an $8,000 program? I know it was worth it. I know what I do is worth well over 10 times more than what I'm producing. It was me. My belief Why are you not charging more? My online fitness membership, it's 5 times more than the usual one out there. Why? Because I know it's worth more. That's what you've got to be asking yourself. No presenter standing up here can do anything unless you believe in yourself right now and you're going to act upon it. The point of all of this is you need to take action on yourself. The only reason I was able to go from the middle of that room last year to standing up here right now being able to give this to was I was able to take action. I was able to follow through and I stuffed up a lot and I laugh about it all the time with a couple of tears now and then. But that's what you need to be. So I want to absolutely, I want to push you, prod you, challenge you, and I want you to make the most out of the next 12 months so you can come here again and you can take leaps and bounds with yourself for all areas of your success. Thank you.
So now it's time for you to click on over to chrisdufay.com. That's chrisdufey.com to get all the guides and show notes. And if you are wanting the workshops where I walk you through how to build your online business, click on over to chrisdufay.com/start here. This is where I can give you the exact training guides and the workshops for exactly where you're at and the answers that you need. Now, every Friday, I'm coming back to you with a new episode. So be sure to subscribe, and if you haven't already, you're going to be getting the world's best insights, the advice, and the answers to give you the business, the money, the freedom, and the success and happiness that you want. And I want to give you a huge muchas gracias for being here with me. And as always, get in touch with me via the site or via social, as Ask the Pro is about me giving you the answers that you need. So ask away.